Hello guys, we are back at last, and we're in an old abandoned classic British boozer. The place is definitely worse for wear. There has been some attempts at renovation. I'm hearing that they're actually thinking of tearing this place down now. It has suffered a few fires. See, look at that. Classic smoke room, so that's where you would have gone for a smoke in there back in the days when you could smoke in pubs. But yeah, you can see there's been fire attempts in here. Roof's seen better days. Old classic, look at that, the old classic fireplace there with the mirror, all original. Kids have been in and smashed the windows as usual. Stairs are looking a bit sketchy up there, but we will get up there nonetheless. So, venturing upstairs. Oh, look at these old posters here. Jesus Christ. Pitching. Somebody's sleeping rough in here then, guys. So there's the old bathroom. So we're on the upper floor now. You can see. These guys out here are picking the litter. Doing a good job for the community. Getting rid of the fly tipping. Do it all off their own back as well. This place is absolutely full of pigeons and pigeon crap everywhere. Just a shell now, unfortunately. You see there, the place is burnt. But once a busy, thriving pub in its time. Fortunately, old pubs like this now, there's not many left. But yeah, these floors have seen better days. I mean, the charcoal basically. I'm watching my step. There's a few floorboards missing there as well. Taking it out to the old kitchen there. Piles and piles of pigeon poop everywhere, guys. But yeah, this one's going to be demolished. Not much left of it now. Just a haven for pigeons to live, I think. That's about it, guys. But it was passing and we thought we'd have a nosy. Because you never know what you might come across. Original fireplace would have been there. Look at the original drawers in the corner still. I mean, looking at this, you can see the workmen have been in here at some point, so there probably was plans to restore it, and they've just given up. Oh, look at this. Meet the Parents. Classic film. Fortunately, it's broken, but yeah, what a film that is. Good old film that. Likes the tea. Pack of tea bags on the floor. So yeah, that is the state of the place. I think it goes up another level actually, guys, so yes it does. So we'll crack on. So this part leads to, yeah, this is just where I was before, guys, downstairs. Yep, I'm that. This has definitely seen better days. About to be ripped down. But was driving past, spotted it, and thought, why not have a nosy? Got lucky, and place was open. So yeah, look at the old banister. Still original. These steps are reasonably sturdy still. I mean, it just goes up and up this place. Another. Okay, so Emma's just nearly gone through the floor. So that's not a good sign. Some sort of storage in there. Everybody's chucked all the old tables and stuff in there, you can see. Little door there. Ah, the original fireplace from downstairs. One of the rooms the fireplace was missing, we found that. Yeah, those floors are wonderful. I can literally feel the floors flexing underneath me. But you can see inside there, there is the original chairs from downstairs. So, yeah, that's where folk would have... What the hell was that? Someone's just come in, guys. I don't think we're alone anymore. Oh, the blue room. Fireplace over there. Also, just a quick advisory, I suppose. Anybody who is thinking of coming to places like this, please don't. You know the risks involved. Like I said, Emma's nearly gone through the floor. I know everybody's getting into exploring now. But yeah, there are a lot of risks involved, and you could quite easily go straight through those floorboards. And bearing in mind we're 3 stories up now, so yeah, just watch what you're doing, guys. Anybody out there thinking of doing this? It's not all fun and games, as it would seem. One false step, well, one wrong move, should I say, or wrong step, and yeah. You down. You can see there, look, the floors are absolutely shot at. Also, another thing I want to mention, at the moment, there's been so many abandoned buildings burned down purely because of retards that go on Facebook share pages and name places. And I want to have a bit of a rant about this today. Yeah, you all know who you are. Couple of people who, shall we say, have visited Scotland recently. Those two people in particular like to name locations. A man and a woman. That's all I'm gonna say. You ought to be ashamed of yourself, because everything you do, you name it. You don't do your own research. All you do is take from others You can't do your own research, and then you then go on your YouTube channel and post it like it's a discovery that only you guys know about, when actually it was handed to you on a plate. So yeah, don't support these people, you know, because they're absolute knobheads, to put it bluntly. And it's because of people naming places that places are getting this kind of stuff happening to them and being set on fire. Luckily this one didn't spread. But yeah, I mean, this one's wrecked, so you know, like I said, this is getting torn down. But the places that have been set on fire in the last 2 weeks haven't been like this at all. Some of them have been absolutely stunning, historical, really beautiful locations, you know, time capsules, things like that. And because of these certain people naming them, yeah, congratulations guys, you've got them wrecked. I'm doing it the genuine way. I'm not going around naming everything. So yeah, you're absolute retards. And all you're doing is taking credit for stuff that you basically have handed to you on a plate. So yeah, just thought I'd have a little rant, guys, because it's been niggling at me for a while. Yeah, look at these. Some of these are like, they must be like amateur films or something, because I've never heard of half of these. These must be like college productions or something. Or if they are, if they are true films, they're very low budget ones like that. So if anybody recognises any, apart from, what's that, Maneater, I'm taking it, that's a rip off of Jaws. So yeah, the old films there, guys. That's about it for this place, really. Like I said, the place is due to be ripped down, but so I'd give you a bit of a tour, and I'd have a bit of a rant about these scumbags that are just creating Facebook pages, naming places, taking all the credit for it. What's the point in naming places? So the tour bus turns up. You know, it's just absolutely ridiculous. I mean, urban exploring is about like keeping history, you know, documenting places like this, not about getting it wrecked and how many people you can hand it to for brownie points or for subs or likes. Because to be honest, that's not the main reason I do this. I do this because I enjoy it. I don't go around, you know, doing other crap and following, I don't know, apps and stuff like that and all that junk, you know. That's just not me. It's not the way I do it. I don't care if I get 1,000 subs. I don't care if I get 2 million subs. I'm not gonna go around and I'm not gonna fake anything and do all this random nautical crap, and you know, because that's what it is. I know some people choose to go down that route, and that's up to them. They've got, you know, bills to pay and things like that. I'm not putting them down. I'm just saying it's not what I want to do. You know, I want to document the bricks and mortar and the history. You know, I'm not about to do it any other way, and I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing. And if you like it, hit that thumbs up and subscribe. If you don't like it, then head over and watch people, I don't know, going down random country lanes by apps that don't work. So, yeah. Take care, guys, and see you all soon. So, we're back at another abandoned location. And this one is an old nightclub. Very, very dark. You can see, look at this on the walls. Some of the bands that have played here over time. There is the old stage. me see. Bar that area there. CJS Music Bar live every Friday night. Not much left of the speakers. So yeah, there might not be much to see here, guys, but we thought we'd have a nosy. Toilet. Yeah, can you imagine back in the time, this would have been like a busy, bustling little bar, you know, with live music and stuff, and you can imagine the people that played here. This is just toilets around here, guys. Yeah, it is, just toilets. So yeah, that's where the band would have been. Bar area over there. There is an upstairs area. So we're gonna go and have a look at that. If we can get up there, guys. With a torch in the way. Oh. Yeah, look at this, guys. This is more like it. Again, fire damaged. Original fireplace there. So yeah, it's good to be back out exploring after a few months out with COVID and everything. But we are back and hopefully get some regular content out. Not just doing the paranormal. We are still doing the paranormal, guys, but we are still doing exploring as well. So thought we'd have a bit of a wander out today. Yeah, look at that. Imagine all the people lined up at that bar there. What a shame. Emma was actually saying to me before we came in, she used to drink in this bar. And yeah, she saw a few bands here. So Emma actually remembers this place back in the day as it was. She used to come here, so. It's quite uncanny, really. What's it feel like coming back to a place that you used to drink and seeing it like this?
No, I don't know. It's a shame, really.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah, because it was pretty good here. You know, it got pretty busy and stuff, so...
Yeah. Somebody's obviously tried to set it on fire at some point. But yeah, what a shame, guys. Real shame. Just showing you around the place, and I mean, this is what I'm stood on. It's just crumbling. Somebody's lost a trainer there. Another seating area. TV's melted. I don't think we'll be getting any reception out of that one. So, just over here is behind the bar. Oh, I've seen better days on it. Something else melted there. I think that's the fire blanket. So much for the fire blanket. Even the old fridge is there, look. What about the drinks in the bench? Bar stool. What a shame.
Also, he went behind the bar.
Yeah, also, guys, I've just been walking around and I don't know if some of you are aware, I used to do the paranormal for a number of years, and I am actually a medium. I do work with a few companies. I do my own live every Wednesday night for Ghost Dimension, and I work with West Yorkshire Paranormal as well. One thing I will say about this place, as soon as I entered upstairs, I was given a projected image of a male. At first his male was quite pushy, as if he didn't want me here, and then he turned out to be quite friendly actually. And he sort of tipped his cap at me. You know how somebody sort of tips the cap at you? I felt as if this male was tipping his cap at me as much to sort of greet me. And he was stood right in that area over there. And he tipped his cap at me as much to say hello. He gave me his name as Brian. So if anybody does know this place and used to drink here and remember Old Brian, he says I was known as Old Brian. Okay? So there's a male here. He was known as Old Brian. He used to bring his own glass, he said. You know, back in the day, before it was a club, he used to bring his own glass, you know, like some of the elders used to do, and they used to bring their own pint glass and they like to drink out of a certain glass. He's showing me this glass, and it's a Stone's Bitter glass that he's showing to me, okay? But yeah, it's a really strange one, so I just thought I'd share that with you guys. I mean, some of you probably don't believe in the paranormal, but that's what I was given when I came into this building straight away. So we're going to head down and out. Hopefully Brian remains happy here. That's the reason why he wants to be here. He's obviously got happy memories here. So we're going to leave Brian to his pint of Stone's Bitter, and we'll see you on the next one, guys. Take care.